Oh, I think we'd be lucky to have a positive rate of growth. You understand that the virus caused this slowdown, and the virus continues to ravage the country. You remember 9/11, we lost 3,000 people. We lose that many every 3 days in this country. Remember the Titanic?
Okay.
1,500 people died. You know, we lose that in a day and a half right now.
But
so
we are
you're
expanding.
Not going to get a recovery of the economy until we deal with the thing that's killing so many people.
We can't get back to where we were in, say, January or February in terms of the overall size of the economy until we've got, what, a vaccine?
A vaccine or another way to control the spread. Testing and isolating would work to control the spread of this virus. Just find out who's infectious, put them into isolation, that'll stop the spread. But we've got to invest in testing if we want to do that.
Okay, but look, I just want to make sure we're all on the same page. Everybody understands what's going on here. We are expanding the economy, correct? We hit a low in the second quarter. We'll move up from there in the third quarter, move up some more from there in the fourth quarter. And as Larry Kudlow says, strong growth next year. We're all on board with that, right?
Well, first, you got to remember, we're recovering from a very deep recession, close to a depression. So we're not even close to getting back to normal. So we're getting a little bit less depressed.
Well,
and the other thing is, you know, the core competence of this administration is dishonesty. So I wouldn't pay attention to anything that somebody like Kudlow says.
Wait, that's a bold statement. The core competency of this administration is, what did you call it? Is
dishonesty.
Dishonesty?
Yeah. I mean,
and
look,
you can't believe something from somebody like Larry Kudlow? That's a hell of a slam, Paul.
Well, I'm just trying to tell you, this is the way I operate. I don't pay any attention to what Kudlow says. No serious economist. By the way, Kudlow isn't an economist. And there's a reason this administration can't hire a real economist is because they only hire liars for hire. So, you know, you get people who will say whatever the administration wants, but you can't get credible people. So I don't pay any attention to what Kudlow says.
I'm going to leave it right there because that was really insulting for many of the people who serve in this administration. And you branded them as flat out liars.
Liars for hire. Yeah. And listen, this is just
No. What you're saying is really rather insulting, Paul. You know, liars for hire. Are you calling Larry Kudlow a liar?
Yeah, of course. He'll say anything that will help this administration
achieve
whatever its goals of the day are.
Kevin Hassett?
And listen, I deal in facts.
Kevin Hassett is a liar?
Upset by the facts. They have to just, look, if you want to hear somebody who will tell you things that aren't true that make you feel good,
what was the lie?
Liars for hire.
What was the lie from Larry Kudlow? What was it?
Oh, I mean, go back and look at his.
He said, wait a minute, I've played the soundbite. 20% growth third and fourth quarter. Is that a lie?
Yeah, first look.
Why is it a lie?
20% growth, it's already a lie because he's presenting these
it's
quarterly growth rates,
Paul,
on an annualized basis.
Statistics.
And then he's saying,
Paul,
he's saying you're going to get 20% growth for two quarters in a row. You can't do that. That's only the kind of growth rate you could get in one quarter. And even that isn't going to happen because nobody's addressed the fundamental problem, which is causing the slowdown. So, I mean, it's a lie to go out and say you can cause growth without even talking about the pandemic.
So it's a lie to forecast growth, which you're not sure will actually hit. Well, I've got to end it because I'm really out of time. And I've got to tell you, Paul, I really don't like people who appear on this program being called liars by someone like you.
I don't think you should do that.
Well, I'll ask him. I'll ask him. I mean, he's on the show. I'll ask him. I'll say, Paul Romer says, you're a liar. Okay?
A liar for hire.
Okay. Thank you, Paul. We appreciate it. We may see you again. All right.